Here's a quiz for you and your technicians. What does NVH stand for? Where is pillar foam found? What is the expansion ratio of foam? What primer is most often recommended under foam? The answers to this quiz may surprise you. If you missed a couple, then you could probably use a reminder on the use and need for automotive foams. Technicians often look at foams in vehicles as almost a nuisance in the repair process, but they're important. Technicians may not understand the ramifications of improperly using or placing them, or not replacing them at all. First, identifying where foams are located is necessary to avoid causing problems during repairs. Procedures for locating foams can be found on manufacturer websites and other sources. Foam in today's vehicles has many functions. One is noise, vibration, and harshness, or NVH. Foams help keep wind noise levels down where airflow is strong, and also reduce road noise from vibration of parts or panels. Foam also keeps water and roadway chemicals from entering where they should not. And foam is used also to keep metal from fatiguing prematurely, such as in door hinge areas. Foam comes in many forms, from soft foam blocks to urethane two-part products. Each type has qualities that serve as reasons why and where it's used. The application of foams can be as simple as shoving them into a void or applying them into a trapezoid-shaped area. Find a way of removing foam that's the least intrusive and least damaging to metal. And remember that any bare metal exposed must be primed according to directions. The application of foams can be as simple as cutting to size and smushing in place. Two-part epoxy and urethane foams, however, will be different in that they will require some thought. Establish access points. Figure out where foams need to be and how to get there. Find out how much foam is needed, and find out the expansion rate of the foam to be used. Once you determine the expansion ratio, you need to be sure the proper mixing tip is used. After the foam is applied, follow vehicle manufacturer's guidelines as to corrosion protection. As far as preformed foams or foams used in bumpers go, it's best to replace damaged ones. Always verify to see that the shop is using the right foams at the right places. Although they may seem like a minor part of the repair, they're not. I'm Jason Stahl. Thanks for watching.